Okay, my dear friends, so let's start the basic of the Fourier transform. Okay, so again, welcome to EduCrack. Let's start the next topic, that is the basic of Fourier transform. यहाँ पर आपको मैं डिस्कस करूंगा बेसिक ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. बेसिक ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म जब हम समझ जाएंगे, इसी का हम मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक में आगे हम यूज करेंगे, है ना. सबसे पहले देखते हैं हम लोग फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म होता क्या है. बेसिक ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. ओके माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म क्यों यूज करते हैं हम लोग. देखिए, फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या करता है, टाइम डोमेन एनालिसिस को फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन में कन्वर्ट करता है. सो फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज नथिंग बट इट कन्वर्ट टाइम डोमेन इनटू द फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन. ओके, सो इट कन्वर्ट द कॉन्टिन्यूअस टाइम डोमेन इनटू द कॉन्टिन्यूअस फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन. कॉन्टिन्यूअस टाइम डोमेन इंटू द कॉन्टिन्यूअस फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन. ओके, सो लेट एफ ऑफ टी हैविंग द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज एफ ऑफ जे ओमेगा, देन एफ ऑफ जे ओमेगा इक्वल टू माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू इन्फिनिटी एफ ऑफ टी e raised to power minus j omega t into dt. So f of j omega is minus infinity to infinity my f of t e raised to power minus j omega t into dt. Here e raised to power minus j omega t, this is called Fourier operator. Now, f of j omega, this is equal to, if put t equal to 0, or we can say omega equal to 0, then what will happen actually here? So, just write down. Area in time domain. Area in time domain is what? Minus infinity to infinity f of t into dt. This represent the area in what? Time domain. So just put omega equal to 0 on both sides. So when put omega equal to 0 on both sides, this is f of j0 equal to minus infinity to infinity f of t into dt. So this property is called area of the time domain. Area of waveform in the time domain. Time domain. Okay. So, my dear friends, omega ka value jab hum 0 put karenge, to minus infinite se infinite f of t dt jo hai, ye area represent karega, aur ye area kahan par represent karega aapka time domain mein. So, this is nothing but your area in your time domain. अब आते हैं हम लोग कि सर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी क्या क्या हैं. व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. नाउ प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज देखेंगे हम लोग, है ना, जिसको हम आगे यूज करने वाले हैं. फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी देखेंगे हम लोग लिनियरिटी, है ना. लिनियरिटी प्रॉपर्टी क्या कहता है, देखिए ध्यान से. मान लिया एक्स वन टी हैविंग द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज एक्स वन जे ओमेगा, एक्स टू टी हैविंग द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज एक्स टू जे ओमेगा. ओके, now if you multiply with a times, then this becomes a times. If you multiply b times, then this becomes b times. So the a times of x1t plus b times of x to t having the Fourier transform is nothing but a times of x1 j omega plus b times of x2 j omega. So if follow this property, then this is called linearity property. So my dear friends, Fourier transform जो है वो follow करेगा किसको? Linearity property को, है ना? So Fourier transform follow the linearity properties, and that linearity properties is a times of x1 t Fourier transform having a times of x1 j omega. So this is called linearity property. Now my dear students, I am going to discuss the next property, and that is called shifting in time domain. That is called shifting property. Shifting in time domain. Shifting in time domain. Okay. Let's say xt having the Fourier transform is x of j omega. Then shifting in time domain, that is x of t plus minus tau. It may be advance or it may be a delay. Okay. Shifting in time domain, this represent it may be advance or it may be delay. Then its Fourier transform is nothing but x of j omega e raised to power plus minus j omega into tau. So plus minus j omega into tau. This is your shifting in time domain properties. Okay. So if it is plus minus, then it is also the plus minus. Just careful. If it is plus minus, then it is also the plus minus. So this is shifting in time domain. Now, third one is shifting in frequency domain. So next property is shifting in frequency domain. So what says this property, my dear friends? Shifting in frequency domain. Let's say x of t having the Fourier transform is x of j omega, then shifting in what? Frequency domain. So x of j omega plus minus omega naught. So if it is shifted plus minus omega naught, then it will happen, then its Fourier transform will be nothing but, then its Fourier transform is equal to x of t. Now it introduce a exponential factor, and this is plus minus now. So in this case your minus plus, so this is minus plus j omega naught into tau. So this is your shifting in frequency domain. So this property represent the shifting in frequency domain. So first one is the linearity property, second property is shifting in time domain property, third property is shifting in frequency domain. Now I am going to discuss next property, my dear students. Now fourth property, let's say fourth property is a scaling property. What says the scaling property? क्या represent करता है scaling property? मान लिया x of t having the Fourier transform is x of j omega, then x of a t, it means scale by a times, x of a t having the Fourier transform, and this is 1 upon mod of a x of j omega by a. This is your scaling property. This property is called a scaling property. Now next is differentiation property. That is differentiation in time domain. So So just write down each and every properties, okay? Just write down each and every one. Each and every property, just write down, my dear friends. What is my dear? Now, next property is differentiation in time domain. What say? Let x of t having the Fourier transform is x of j omega. Then the Fourier transform of differentiation in time domain, this is equal to j omega into x of j omega. So this is the Fourier transform of differentiation in what? Time domain. Okay. Now next one is differentiation in frequency domain. Differentiation in frequency domain. What represent, my dear friends, differentiation in frequency domain? Let x of t having the Fourier transform is x of j omega. X of t having the Fourier transform is what? X of j omega. Then minus j t into x of t having the Fourier transform, and this Fourier transform is nothing but dx of j omega upon d omega. And you can write here t into x of t having the Fourier transform is equal to j dx of j omega upon d omega. So this is the property differentiation in frequency domain. So these are the properties: differentiation in time domain, differentiation in frequency domain. This is the linearity property, shifting in time domain, shifting in frequency domain. So these are the basic properties, scaling properties. These are the basic properties, my dear friends. Now I'm going to discuss the next properties, and this is your convolutions. So next property is convolutions property. Next property is whatever your 6 or 7. This is convolution property. Convolution in time domain. Convolution in time domain is equal to convolution in frequency domain. Sorry, multiplication in frequency domain. Multiplication in frequency domain. So, my dear friends, convolution in time domain is equal to multiplication in what? Frequency domain. Okay. So, let's say x1t having the Fourier transform is x1 j omega. X1t having the Fourier transform is x1 j omega. X2t having the Fourier transform is x2 j omega. Then x1t convolve with x2t. This is the sign of convolutions. Okay. So x1t convolve with x2t having the Fourier transform is nothing but x1 j omega into x2 j omega. So my dear friends, here convolution in what? Convolution in time domain. Then this is multiplication in what? Frequency domain. Got it? So convolution in time domain is equal to multiplication in frequency domain. This is called convolution property. क्या बोलेंगे इसको हम? Convolution property. Got it? तो अगर टाइम डोमेन में कन्वोल्यूशन है तो उसको फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन में जब रखेंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा आपका? मल्टीप्लीकेशन हो जाएगा. सो कन्वोल्यूशन इन टाइम डोमेन इज सेम एज इट इज कॉल्ड मल्टीप्लीकेशन इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन. दिस इज कॉल्ड मल्टीप्लीकेशन प्रॉपर्टी. और वी कैन से कन्वोल्यूशन इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन, इफ यू कैन राइट हियर कन्वोल्यूशन इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन, एक्स ऑफ जे ओमेगा कन्वॉल्व विद एक्स टू जे ओमेगा. And this is Fourier transform is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi. This is x1t into x2t. Got it? So these are the properties of your Fourier transform. Now I'm going to discuss the basic types of Fourier transform. Let's say first one, impulse function del of t. This is infinite at t equal to 0. And minus infinite to infinite del of t into dt, this is equal to 1. If you want to plot in the time domain, then this is your impulse function at t equal to 0. This is 1. My dear friends, this 1 is not the strength, not the magnitude. This is the strength. This is the power, not the magnitude. Okay? So this is called impulse functions. Now the Fourier transform of impulse function f of j omega, this is minus infinity to infinity del of t e raised to power minus j omega t into dt. Just put here and you will get e raised to power minus j omega t at put t equal to what? 0. This is equal to 1 by using the impulse property. Okay. So f of j omega is what? F of j omega equal to 1. So if you plot the frequency domain spectrum, then f of j omega equal to 1, this is the constant value. So this is your constant value and this is nothing but your DC value. This represent the DC value. So impulse function time domain mein hai, t equal to 0 per magnitude infinite. तो यही फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन में बन जाएगा कैसा? डीसी वैल्यू. अब आते हैं नेक्स्ट हम लोग. यूनिट स्टेप फंक्शन. यू ऑफ टी, दिस इज 1 फॉर टी ग्रेटर देन 0 एंड 0 फॉर टी लेस देन 0. देयर इज नो इनइक्वालिटी साइन. So there is no inequality sign, so you can't integrate. So f of j omega, you cannot write 0 to infinity 1 e raised to power minus j omega t into dt. And when you will integrate, this is 1 upon j omega, which is wrong. It is not the Fourier transform of this unit step function. It is the Laplace transform. It is your Laplace transform, my dear friends. Okay, not the Fourier transform. Got it? So it is your Laplace transform, not the Fourier transform of f of j omega. This is for the unit step functions. Now how you can find the unit step functions? So before starting the unit step function, you have to know what is the signum functions. So the signum function of t is equal to 1 for t greater than 0 minus 1 for t less than 0. When you represent this one, this is 1, this is minus 1. This is t greater than 0, this is 1, t less than 0, this is minus 1, and this is called signum function of t. So this function is nothing but signum function of t. Now my dear friends, it is not continuous at t equal to 0. Ye t equal to 0 pe continuous nahi hai. It is not continuous at t equal to 0. So it should be continuous at t equal to 0. That's why we defined a function which is continuous at t equal to 0. So the signum function of t can be modified This is limit a tends to 0. Tends to 0. E raised to power minus a t u of t. For t greater than 0. And limit a tends to 0. Minus e raised to power a t u of minus t. For t less than 0. Now while you put this a tends to 0 value, this becomes 1 for t greater than 0. This becomes minus 1 for t less than 0. Okay. Now you can integrate easily. Because exponential functions are continuous at t equal to 0. Now you can just signum function of omega is nothing but this is 0 to infinity e raised to power minus a t e raised to power minus j omega t into dt plus minus infinity to 0 minus of e raised to power a t e raised to power minus j omega t into dt. And when you integrate, this becomes 1 upon a plus j omega, and this becomes 1 upon a minus j omega. Okay, so this becomes your minus a upon a minus j omega. Now here limit what a tends to 0. So while putting a tends to 0, this becomes twice of j omega. So the signum function of t having the Fourier transform, this is twice of j omega. Twice of j omega. Got it, my dear friends? Is it clear? Now, by using the signum function of t, you can easily find out for the unit step functions. So how you can find the for the unit step functions? So my dear friends, as you know that the unit step functions can be right here 1 plus signum function of t 1 by 2. How? Because u of t for t greater than 0, this is 1. So this is 1 for t greater than 0 and 0 for t less than 0. So you can write here u of t equal to 1 by 2 into 1 plus signum function of t. Now I will apply here linearity property. So while you apply the linearity property, you will get the answer. Now, the constant function a having the Fourier transform is 2 pi a into del omega. How? This is the part of the signal system. So this is 2 pi a into del omega. So this is u of t equal to what? 1 by 2, 1 plus signum function of t. So here you can write here 1 by 2. 1 ko kya li sakte aap? 2 pi into del omega plus 2 by j omega, and this will be equal to 1 by j omega plus pi del omega. So u of omega equal to pi del omega plus 1 by j omega. This is the Fourier transform. This is the Fourier transform. What? U of t. Not the 1 upon j omega. It is nothing but it will be equal to 1 by j omega plus pi del omega. So this is your Fourier transform. Got it, my dear friends? Now, my dear students, I am going to discuss next. Sampling function. Sampling function क्या होता है? सैंपलिंग फंक्शन कैसे रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे हम सैंपलिंग फंक्शन को, इसे देखते हैं. सैंपलिंग फंक्शन इज रिप्रेजेंट एज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज
सैंपलिंग
sampling of theta is equal to sine theta by theta, and the limit theta tends to 0, sampling of theta, this is limit theta tends to 0 sine theta by theta, and this is equal to 1. So this value is nothing but equal to 1. This is sampling of theta. So limit theta tends to 0 is sine theta by theta, and this is equal to 1. This is called sampling functions. Now sampling functions can be also write sinc functions. Now sinc of x equal to sine pi x upon pi x. Be careful, my dear friends, here pi is omitted, okay, sinc of x, so this is pi factor. This can be write here sampling of pi x. So sinc of x equal to sine pi x upon pi x, and this can be also write sampling of pi x. Now this is sampling functions is very very important in your communication systems. If you want to draw this graph, then this is nothing but your sampling of theta is what? Sine theta by theta. So sine theta will be 0 if theta equal to n pi. That is for n pi, for different value of n pi, the sine theta will be 0, and this will give your crossing points. This is nothing but your crossing points. Let's say this is theta. This is sampling of theta. Now theta versus sampling of theta graph is what? How you can draw? This is maximum at theta equal to 0 and this is equal to 1. And if you increase the theta, amplitude will be decreases. If you increase the theta, amplitude will be decreases. And the maximum at theta tends to 0, this is equal to 1. This is for pi minus pi, 2 pi minus 2 pi, 3 pi minus 3 pi, and जैसे जैसे आप बढ़ाते चले जाएंगे ये डिके होता जाएगा, ये भी डिके होता जाएगा. So this is nothing but decaying slope. कैसा slope है सारा? Decaying slope. 98% of the total energy is conserved about minus pi to pi of total energy, or you can say total strength. Okay, so why wastage of the bandwidth? इसलिए हम इसको क्या करते हैं, एक low pass filter से pass करते हैं, and after passing through the low pass filter, just extract the original message signal, and this is from minus pi to plus pi. So this is your theta equal to n pi, and this will represent the sampling of theta, my dear friends. So this is, these all factors are represent the sampling of theta, and it will be varied from minus pi to pi, that is it contains the 98% of the energy. So the same graph of the sinc of x. So sampling of pi x and sinc of x having the same graph. दोनों का कैसा ग्राफ होगा सर? सेम ग्राफ होगा आपका, चाहे वो सैम्पलिंग ऑफ थीटा रखे, चाहे वो सिंक ऑफ एक्स रखे, दोनों का ग्राफ आपका क्या होगा? सेम ग्राफ होगा. एंड क्रॉसिंग पॉइंट यहाँ पर हम देख लेंगे. दिस इज योर सैम्पलिंग ऑफ थीटा. नाउ यहाँ पर एक टर्म हम डिफाइन करेंगे, गेट फंक्शन, एंड देखते हैं कि गेट फंक्शन का फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या होगा. जस्ट राइट ऑन. Now I am going to decide that is gate function. इसी को बोलते हैं हम rectangular function. So the gate function f of t can be right here. A amplitude rect T by tau, rect T by tau, where A is amplitude, tau is width. So this is A rect T by tau, that is A varied from minus tau by 2 to tau by 2. So this is amplitude A and this is your f of t. This is called gate function. Or this is also called rectangular function. Now the Fourier transform of gate function is f of j omega, and this can be right here minus tau by 2 to tau by 2 a e raised to power minus j omega t into dt. Just integrate them. Integrate कीजिए तो ये बनेगा आपका a by j omega e raised to power minus j omega t. This is minus tau by 2 to tau by 2. So the f of j omega can be right here a by j omega e raised to power j omega tau by 2 minus e raised to power minus j omega tau by 2. Okay, just integrate कीजिए इसको, बताइए क्या आ रहा है. Just integrate करना है. ओके चलिए जब इसको इंटीग्रेट करेंगे माय डियर फ्रेंड्स माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स देन व्हाट विल हैपन एक्चुअली ए बाय जे ओमेगा मल्टीप्लाई विद द 2j डिवाइड विद द 2j इट इज जे ओमेगा टॉ बाय 2 जे ओमेगा टॉ बाय 2 डिवाइडेड बाय 2j. So f of j omega can be right here two a by omega sine omega tau by 2. Two a by omega sine omega tau by 2. Now these functions can be converted into the sampling functions. So what actually sampling is function? Sampling theta is what? Sine theta by theta. So theta is what? Omega tau by 2. So you can write here just omega. So just 2a by omega. You can write here sine omega tau by 2 divide omega tau by 2 multiply with omega tau by 2 and you will get this is this is sampling theta. Omega omega cancel out, 2 2 cancel out, this becomes a tau sampling omega tau by 2. So the Fourier transform of the rectangular function is your nothing but sampling function. This represent the sampling functions. So Fourier transform of rectangular function is your sampling functions. चलिए just draw कीजिए इसको. Now for sine theta equal to 0, that is sine omega tau by equal to 0, omega tau by 2 should be equal to n pi. So this omega is nothing but 2 n pi by tau. So f is n by tau. So actually domain is f. Now this is your frequency f. This is your maximum. is F equal to 0. Now crossing point is what? N by tau. Now put here different types of N. N equal to 1, 2, 3. Now this becomes your 1 by tau. This becomes 2 by tau. Minus 1 by tau. Minus 2 by tau. And this maximum value is A tau. This is your F of J omega. Got it? Is it clear, my dear friends? So F of J omega equal to A tau sampling omega tau by 2. So this is your sampling functions. Chali. अब देखेंगे लोग ट्रायंगुलर फंक्शंस को कैसे निकालेंगे. दिस इज टाइम डोमेन ट्रायंगुलर फंक्शंस. माइनस टी टू टी एम्पलीट्यूड इज ए. इसका फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म जो होगा जस्ट राइट डाउन ए टी sampling square omega t by 2. And if you plot this graph, this is the square function. So there is no any negative value. So it will be always positive value. And this is your graph of, again, this is 1 minus 1 by t, this is 1 by t, minus 1 by t, 2 by t, minus 2 by t, this is a t. So this is your sampling square omega t by 2. A t sampling square omega t by 2. And this is for t, and this is t equal to 0 point. Got it? So this is a t sampling square omega t by 2. This is your Fourier transform of triangular functions. तो इस तरह से बेसिक ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म है जिसको हम फर्दर यूज करेंगे. जैसे कुछ पॉइंट्स अभी हम देखेंगे यहाँ पर. एज फॉर एग्जांपल अगर आपसे पूछा जाए कि व्हाट इज द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ ए कॉस ओमेगा टी या ओमेगा नॉट टी, सो इसको क्या लिख सकते हैं आप? ए रेज़ टू पावर j omega naught t plus e raised to power minus j omega naught t divided by 2. Okay? So 1 ka Fourier transform kya hoga? 2 pi del omega. So e raised to power j omega naught t ka Fourier transform kya hoga? To isko kya karenge aap? 2 pi into, dekho yahan plus hai na, yahan minus ho jayega. Del omega minus omega naught. e raise to power minus j omega naught t का फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या बन जाएगा? तो अगर इसका फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म निकालना है तो ये बन जाएगा 2 pi del of omega plus omega naught बन जाएगा, है ना? चलिए अब यहाँ पर पुट करेंगे आप तो क्या बनेगा सर? देखिए फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म, फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म बन जाएगा आपका a by 2 2 pi del of omega minus omega naught del of omega plus omega naught, 2 2 cancel out, and this will becomes this is omega. So 1 each at omega equal to minus omega naught, another each at omega equal to plus omega naught. This value is what? A into pi. Amplitude is A into pi. So this is nothing but your sampling impulse function. What function? Impulse function. If you write in the frequency domain, so in the frequency domain what will happen? Just divide by 2 pi. So at f equal to f naught, this is a by 2. This is f equal to minus of f naught, this is a by 2. Why? Just divide by 2 pi. Then this becomes what? Frequency. Okay. So omega and frequency both having the omega equal to what? 2 pi f. So f can be right here omega by 2 pi. Okay. So this is your omega and frequency characteristics. So sinusoidal functions का कैसा बन गया? Impulse function Fourier transform. And sinusoidal में अभी देख रही हम कौन सा? Cos की बात. अगर हम sin की बात करें हम sin functions का तो क्या बनेगा देखिए. Now Fourier transform of a sin omega naught t. So f of t can be right here a by 2 j e raised to power j omega naught t minus e raised to power minus j omega naught t. This can be right here a upon 2 j, this is 2 pi del of omega naught minus 2 pi del of omega plus omega naught. Now this becomes your 2, 2 cancel out. Now this becomes minus, or you can say in the frequency domain, just divided by 2 pi. Now this becomes a by 2 j. Now you can write here del of f minus f naught, del of f plus f naught. Just draw a spectrum. This is your frequency f. At f equal to f naught, this is a by 2j, and f equal to f minus f naught, this is your minus a by 2j. So this is your spectrum, frequency domain spectrum, and this is nothing but your Fourier transform. Fourier transform of what? A sine omega naught t signal. Got it? So these are the Fourier transform of the signals, and this is nothing but your a cos omega naught t and a sin omega naught t. Okay, my dear friends, now I'm going to discuss in the next video lecture what is the bandwidth, what is the band of frequency, and how you can extract the AM signals, and how you can just elaborate the AM signals. So design of the AM signals and how you can generate the AM signals, I'm going to discuss in your next video lecture. Thank you so much.